Welcome to Bhatt and Bhatt Tutorials. I am Seshadri, faculty for English. This session is for 10th grade CBSE English. We are going to do a lesson in this. The name of the lesson is A Letter to God by G.L. Fuentes. So let us see what the lesson says. Dear students, before we actually start the lesson, there are a few questions which is posed by the author. It says, they say faith can move mountains, but what should we put our faith in? This is the question this story delicately poses. In fact, this lesson gives us three different points to think about. The first point is faith. Obviously, when we talk of faith, it is a faith in God. There are people who have a blind faith in God, who have a very unshaken belief in God. There are people who have faith but have some reservations. It varies from person to person. For example, the farmer in this lesson, his name is Lencho. He is a farmer who writes a letter to God when his crops are ruined, asking for 100 pesos. Dear students, the currency referred to here is pesos. Pesos is a currency which is used in about 8 countries, many of them in Latin America or South America. Some of the countries are Argentina, Chile, and Mexico. This story could have occurred in any one of these countries where a peso is the currency. Again, 1 peso is divided into 100 cents. Like 1 rupee is divided into 100 paisa. 1 peso is divided into 100 cents. Somewhere down the chapter, we also come to a place where we refer to cents. So, coming back to the question of faith, Lencho has a blind faith in God, and that faith is what makes him write a letter to God. Now, the question we need to ask is, does Lencho's letter reach God? Does God send him the money? Definitely, each of the students may have a different opinion on this. Somebody may say a miracle may happen and it may reach God and God may send him money. Some may say there is no such thing as writing a letter to God, so the money would never come. That is again a question of discussion. But again, the main point that is there here is the kind of faith the farmer had. And like many of the people who live in the countryside, he is like an innocent person. He is a naive person. Naive is a new word for you. It is spelt as N-A-I-V-E. A person who is less informed, or a person who doesn't have much information about worldly things. So this farmer thinks that God is really a person with an address, and he writes a letter to him. Now, each one of us may have our own answer to this. Saying, some may say yes, some may say no, but let us see what actually happens. That is one part where this lesson is points to, where this lesson points to, that is faith. The second point which this lesson tells us is the kind of distress that farmers face when their crops fail. Now, students, we all know India is a vast agricultural country with a large number of people engaged in agriculture. Almost 60 to 70% of our population still lives in villages, and a large percentage of them are into farming. In this, people who depend totally on irrigation or totally on rains for irrigation, rains for water, are at the mercy of nature. People who have got access to say state developed irrigation like canals and tanks, yes, they don't have to depend on rains. They have a source of water supply. Farmers who have got, say, a borewell in their locality, they are also not dependent. But a vast majority of our farmers, just like our farmer in the story Lencho, they are dependent on rains. And how their lives get ruined when the crops get spoiled due to lack of rain or due to excess rain. Both are harmful. Now, this is also, and this story we see even in our country, every year, many a time it gets repeated. Even last year, there were floods in North Karnataka and a lot of standing crops got spoiled. And the farmers faced such distress that the government was forced to move in and waive off some of their crop loans. So that is also a scene which happens in India. The third point here is what we do at the end of the chapter is an activity wherein students, you will have to actually go into a post office and send a money order. So once you do that, you will be able to see how money is transferred, and you will be able to get to know some new terms which is associated with that. So shall we begin? The house, the only one in the entire valley, sat on the crest of a low hill. From this height, one could see the river and the field of ripe corn dotted with flowers that always promised a good harvest. The only thing earth needed was a downpour, or at least a shower. So downpour, basically downpour is, we are referring to rain. And the other new word here is crest. Crest means top. Crest means top of a hill. So the house was situated on the top of a low hill. We can also see from here that the corn was just about ready for harvest, and what it needed was one last watering or one last shower of rain. Now, throughout the morning, Lencho, he is the farmer. Throughout the morning, Lencho, who knew his fields intimately, had nothing else but see the sky towards the northeast. Now, definitely each and every farmer who works with his own hands, who's a hands-on agriculturist, definitely he knows his fields intimately. Intimately, the meaning of the word intimately means very closely. So he like keeps looking into the sky, and it is from the northeast direction of his field that he expects the clouds to come. So he is watching, waiting for the clouds and waiting for rain to start. So when he sees the clouds, he starts talking to his wife there. Now, we are really going to get some water, woman. Now, the woman in this case is his wife. The woman who was preparing supper replied, "Yes, God willing." The older boys were working in the field while the smaller ones were playing near the house until the woman called to them all, "Come for dinner." Here again, even the lady of the house, it shows that has a firm belief in God. So she says, "Yes, God willing. If God wills, the rain will come." So they are a deeply religious family. That is what this tells us. Now, since supper was ready, they have started eating. It was during the meal that, just as Lencho had predicted, big drops of rain began to fall. In the northeast, huge mountains of clouds could be seen approaching. The air was fresh and sweet. Definitely a much awaited rain. Definitely it brings about a lot of cheer in the people, and it even clears up the air of any pollution and heat that is there. So that is why this air was fresh and sweet. So as expected, the rains started. Now, though they were having food, Lencho goes out. The man went out for no other reason than to have the pleasure of feeling the rain on his body. And when he returned, he exclaimed, "These aren't raindrops falling from the sky. They are new coins. The big drops are 10 cents and the little ones are fives." Now, like we said, the currency of the country there is a peso, and one peso has 100 cents. He is referring to the raindrops as new coins. It is obvious that once he has a good rain, once he has a good rain for the final harvest, he will be able to collect a good harvest of his corn, and then he will be able to get a great deal of money. So he is comparing the raindrops with currency. That's why he says, these are not raindrops falling, they are actually new coins. With a satisfied expression, he regarded the field of ripe corn with its flowers draped in a curtain of rain. So he was very satisfied. That was what was highly expected, and the rain did come, and he was happy. Lencho was very happy. But then what happens? But suddenly a strong wind began to blow, and along with the rain, very large hailstones began to fall. These truly did resemble new silver coins. The boys, exposing them to the rain, ran out to collect the frozen pearls. Now, disaster has struck, because what should have been a normal rain has become a hailstorm. Hailstones, we know, or in local language, it is in Kannada, it is known as anekalu. So it is like, these are stones of ice which fall. Sometimes they fall. So this is what happened there. So rain which was falling suddenly started blowing down large hailstones. And like he had compared the raindrops to currency, this is really physically they could see that the pieces of ice, and that is why the children, they ran out to collect the frozen pearls just to play in the rain. But as Lencho is observing, he comments, "It is really getting bad now," exclaimed the man. "I hope it passes quickly." It did not pass quickly. For an hour, the hail rained on the house, the garden, the hillside, the cornfield, and the whole valley. The field was white, as if covered with salt. Normal phenomenon that is associated with a hailstone, with a hailstorm, which contains hailstones, is it happens for a short while and then stops and you have normal rain. But unfortunately, in this case, the whole of the hour, it was those hailstones which were raining. And because those hailstones were in a large quantity, it looked as though the entire field was covered with salt. Definitely this was bad news. So he says, that is why he says it is really getting bad now, and he wanted it to pass away quickly. But it did not pass away quickly. Then, what happened because of this hailstorm, because of the hailstones? Not a leaf remained on the trees. The corn was totally destroyed. The flowers were gone from the plants. Now what happens? It is like a solid object. It is like a stone falling on the cornfield. Definitely, it is like somebody is trying to knock off the corn. So that is what the hailstones did. That is what the hail did when it rained upon the entire field, including whatever little flowers were there on the plants. Even those were gone. So looking at this, definitely Lencho's soul was filled with sadness. When the storm had passed, he stood in the middle of the field and said to his sons, a plague of locusts would have left more than this. Now, dear students, a plague of locusts. As we know, locusts are one category of grasshopper. What these locusts do is generally they fly in large swarms. It is called a swarm of locusts. It's even called a plague of locusts. In thousands of numbers, they come and land on the fields which are ripe. And once they land on a particular crop, they start eating all the crop. And they start eating it and they further move on and move on to the next field. In fact, even in this year, this is happening right now as we are speaking. It is happening in India also. There are many areas in Rajasthan which have been affected by locust. In fact, there is a particular authority in India which monitors this locust. It is an annual phenomenon, and the government takes necessary steps. They spray pesticide so that the locust will die. But the reference to the locust here is, Lencho is telling, he's telling his sons that even if locusts would have come and gone, they would have left some corn, but this hail has left nothing for us. This year we will have no corn. Now, here is a case where the farmer is in distress, a very common phenomenon which happens to a large number of farmers. They would have had expected a bounty harvest. They would have had committed, they would have had taken loans. They would have taken loan to sow the crop. They would have planned for so many expenses. But suddenly, just like that, the entire crop fails and they are in total misery. This happens year after year in many countries, happens many a time in India also. That night was a sorrowful one. All our work for nothing. They have one entire season. They have toiled. They have worked. The father and the son and the mother, the entire family has worked for the sowing and for the fertilizers and for the water and for the care of the crop. All that has gone. There is no one who can help us. We'll all go hungry this year. See how miserable his life has become in just 1 hour of a bad weather. Now, this is students, we have to note, this is the kind of risk that is there. And practically speaking, one way this risk is covered is, nowadays, the government advises all the farmers to go in for crop insurance. In case this thing happens, they'll be easily able to claim back some part of the money at least, so that they don't land in this kind of distress. So what happens? Next. But in the hearts of all who lived in that solitary house in the middle of the valley, there was a single hope, help from God. Don't be so upset, even though this seems like a total loss. Remember, no one dies of hunger. So now this is a kind of a conditioning, or this is a kind of a training, which even maybe he as a youngster, even his parents would have told him that come what may, there is always a ray of hope, and that is help from God. And which says, that's what they say, no one dies of hunger. So now that there is absolutely no corn, there is only one way out, but that is help from God. Now, Lencho's faith in God is it's blind faith. He's got an unshaken faith in God. He is 100% sure. In fact, as we see here, all through the night, Lencho thought only of his one hope, the help of God, whose eyes, as he had been instructed, see everything, even what is deep in one's conscience. Now, this is the level of his faith in God, that he thinks that God would even physically see something that is deep in your conscience. What is a conscience? The conscience is our knowledge of right or wrong that is there. Now, Lencho was an ox of a man, working like an animal on the fields, but still he knew how to write. Another point to note here, dear students, is this line: Lencho was an ox of a man. It is actually a figure of speech. It is called a simile. Simile means his physique is being compared to an ox. An ox is generally a very strong thing. Now, when we say Lencho was an ox of a man, this is a simile which tells us that he was a very physically a very strong person. But though he was a farmer and used to do only physical work, he was still literate. He knew how to write. The following Sunday, so what does he do next? Now his only hope is in God. What does he do? He thinks about it. And then the following Sunday, at daybreak, he began to write a letter which he himself would carry to town and place it in the mail. It was nothing less than a letter to God. The student, you see, now his hope is so strong and his faith is so blind that he physically writes a letter, and then he was planning to carry it to town and post it as he would post it in the mail as he would do to any other normal letter. Dear students, with this we end this particular session of this lesson, A Letter to God, which we will continue in the next session. Thank you. And in any doubts on this session, you can contact us on these numbers, or you can even send a message in Bhat and Bhat Tutorials mobile app chat section. Thank you.